Now we're gonna say fundamentally, when looking at any balanced equation, here we have a simple one. A is changing into B. Okay? Now A could be any type of compound, B could be any type of compound. But fundamentally, this is a balanced chemical equation. We're gonna say when looking at any chemical equation, we're gonna say in the simplest way, it's just our reactants breaking down to give us products. And if we take a look at the time elapsed, when we start out at 0 seconds, right? Initially, all we have are the white balls. Those are A. So in the beginning, before a reaction is even allowed to start, we have only reactants. And take a look, over time, what begins to happen? Over time, you're gonna get more and more of compound B, our product forming. Now, the more our product forms, the less reactants we're gonna have around. Because remember, the products are made from our reactants breaking down. Eventually, we'll say that our reaction reaches completion. So we're gonna say when our reaction reaches completion, basically almost all of the reactants are gone and all we have are products. We're gonna say for reactions that go to completion, we have one single arrow going forward. Later on, we're gonna learn about reactions that don't reach equilibrium, that don't reach completion, but actually reach equilibrium. At those states, we're not gonna have a single arrow going forward. We're gonna have two arrows, one's going forward and one's going backwards. We're gonna say when we have double arrows, we're at equilibrium. And when we get to states of equilibrium, we don't get rid of our reactants. Eventually, we're gonna have some reactants and products basically living in harmony with each other, living in equilibrium. For now, we're just gonna be worried about reactions going to completion, but eventually we're gonna get to the point where we should realize that sometimes chemical reactions go to equilibrium.